He was killed. He was murdered. When you see here, like, good man, then about doing good, nice things he did, he helped people, helped the poor man, he died. What kind of emotion can you get? Quite a pity, this poor, nice man. He was killed. And immediately asked two questions. Who killed him? And for what purpose? What was the cause? You see a very different Jesus. We need to, see, we have learned many things in life. We need to unlearn when you go for education. Relearn. Learning, unlearning, relearning, then becomes a learning again. And this is a continuous process. Therefore we need to go back to Jesus, who was a threat to the religious aristocracy, you know, and to the secular aristocracy. Mission cannot be anything less than sharing Jesus' vision, you know, and carrying it forward today in today's context. That is, now I think with regard to that, I just mentioned something the other day. I would like a little expand that, you know. Our mission command is always in terms of Matthew 28 and Mark 16, you know. Then I said, this must be read in the light of Matthew chapter 5, verse 13 to 16. The other day I just mentioned, since there was no time, I just rapidly went, ran through. See, kind of this mission, basing on Matthew and Mark, this has led to aggressive mission. And the aggressive mission ending up there in crusades. You know, the cross did not come alone. The cross came with a sword. When Constantine entered the church, Christ went out of the church. No, Constantine was baptized, not because he believed in Jesus and then, you know, he was converted and all that. He did not want his kingdom, Roman kingdom, to be crushed in his own time. Then he saw another movement that was coming up, and that was the Jesus movement. It was not known as Christianity. So he said, let me go and be baptized, therefore my kingdom will not come down, at least in my time. Afterwards, let it go to the dark side of the mind. No, this is also sometimes we do that. As long as I am superior, I am in the formation, I will see that. Afterwards, let it go to the dark side of the mind. This is not part of the vision. The vision is shared by all people in that community. So now, when you come to this, you see that salt, light, city at the hilltop. Therefore, this mission is not Christ-centered. It's not Christ-centered. Who made disciples? This is not even church-centered. You know, implanting a church. Go and start a new parish, you build a new church. This is centered, God-centered. And how do we reach out to Him? How do we glorify Him? By our good works. And therefore, this is witness. Through our witness, God will be glorified. You know, I still remember in a children's hospital in Chennai, there was a Marxist who was dying, terminally ill, dying of cancer. And he was well taken care of by the sisters who were working there. And before his death, he seems to have kind of said this, you know, how wonderful your sisters are. Not even my mother, not even my wife took care of me so well as you do. If you do all that in the name of God, you know, this is only a reflection. That God in whom you have your trust must be a really wonderful man coming from a Marxist who does not believe in God. And this is the witness. And therefore, I do not want to take much of our time. And people, in the words of Pope Francis, people listen to others who bear witness. Therefore, they listen to what they say. You know? So our preaching, our speaking should be a derivative part of that witness. Being. Then we can, you know. Now this being said, let me Nitya. Shall we take a break and some of
the
time that you gave to me is over?
No, no, we'll take some more time. This is a very good coherence because we have a connection, you see. The whole history, what the purpose of religion is, the purpose of the religion is based on this continuation. We'll go for a coffee break. We'll come back at 10:50. Okay, 15 minutes?
Yes.
Huh? 15 minutes. Okay, thank you.